So we are given the following data about the problem. There is a production function y equals minimum KL, and there are 100 units of capital available in this economy. Labor supply function is provided to us, which is a 50W, and we are assuming that markets are competitive. All markets are competitive, labor market, capital market, as well as the market for output. So the question that we have to solve here is this, that given this data, what will be the equilibrium wage and rental rates in this market? Okay. So I'm going to denote wage by little w, as was in the labor supply function, and I'm going to denote rental rate by little r. Okay. So let's solve this problem. We're going to begin with output market. Now, in the output market, we have perfect competition here, and the production function is minimum LK. So every unit of output that is produced using labor and capital in an efficient way requires one unit of labor and one unit of capital. Okay, so every unit of output that is produced is going to cost W plus R. Okay, because W is the price of labor and R is the price of capital. Okay. So if price of output, which we are assuming here is 1, okay, that's numerator, wage and rental rate, everything are in terms of this output. Okay. So if 1 is greater than W plus R, then there'll be a problem, because a price of output is greater than W plus R. So firm can make infinite profits, and a firm would like to demand infinite amount of labor and infinite amount of capital in such circumstances. But since capital is only 100 units, okay, so this cannot be market clearing. This kind of situation cannot be market clearing, okay, because that's going to lead to excess demand for inputs. And if 1 is less than W plus R, then the per unit price that the firm is going to get from selling the output is going to be 1, but it's going to cost them W plus R, which is greater than 1. So in this situation, the firm is going to make a decision that it's not going to produce anything, and hence will not demand any amount of capital or labor. And if that happens, and we know that the supply of capital is 100 units, so this situation would lead to excess supply of capital. Okay. Now the only case that is left is 1 is equal to W plus R. Okay. In this situation, firm is indifferent, and a firm can demand or any amount of capital and any amount of labor. So now we are going to look at the input market to see what will be the wage and the rental rate at which output market and input market will clear simultaneously. We already have established that if at all there is a competitive equilibrium, it must be the case that W plus R must be 1. So what we're going to do is we're going to divide this problem into two cases. One is W is between 0 and 1, and the next case is that W is equal to 1 and R is 0. Okay, so in this case, R is just 1 minus W. Okay. So if W is between 0 and 1, then labor demand is greater than or equal to capital demand. Okay, that's for sure, because W is going to be either 0, or it's going to be strictly between 0 and 1. If it is strictly between 0 and 1, and in that case R is also going to be strictly between 0 and 1, and since it's a minimum LK, a Leontief production function, so the firm would demand equal amounts of labor and capital. However, if W is 0, then it can demand more labor than capital. So labor demand, whenever wage is going to be between 0 and 1, is always going to exceed the demand for capital. And for market to be in equilibrium, it must be the case that capital demand must be equal to capital supply. Okay, and we know that supply of capital is 100 units, and labor supply is 50W. Now whenever W is between 0 and 1, 100 will always exceed 50 W. So that's labor supply. Okay, so we know that for all values between 0 and 1, it is always going to be the case that labor demand will be strictly higher than the labor supply. So no wage between 0 and 1 can be market clearing. Okay, so so this is again ruled out. So the last possibility is that W is 1 and R is 0. Now if that happens, then we do have market clearing, because when W is 1, labor supply is going to be 50 units. Okay, and labor demand, well, that can be anything that is going to make it, make things market clearing. So labor supply is equal to 50, and we're going to make it equal to labor demand, because firm can demand any amount of labor. Okay, capital demand must exceed labor demand because R is 0. So capital demand can be any number greater than or equal to 50. So we can say that, okay, if it is 100, it is completely fine. Okay, and that's equal to capital supply. Okay, so when wage is 1 and rental rate is 0, then we have equilibrium. Okay, thank you.